Okay, the clawhammer style. The clawhammer style sounds a lot like somebody playing the spoons. Ta ta ka ta ta ka ta ta ka ta ta ka ta ta ka. I'm not sure if you've heard that, or somebody playing their knees. And if we play that in a regular strum, it would sound like this. But the clawhammer has a distinct style. It sounds more like this. Which has got a real a nice bluegrass or country vibe to it. So there are a lot of people describe the movement of the clawhammer technique by saying bum ditty bum ditty bum ditty bum ditty. And that gives you three distinct phases. The first one is the bum phase, which is just dropping your nail through the string like this. Don't flick your finger, just drop your nail through the string like this. And you can practice that a lot. Just try and get nice single notes that way. It's okay if you hit the adjacent string, as long as you don't sound it. You can practice scales like that. Or simple melodies. Until you get kind of confident about playing single notes that way. My students find that helpful. And then the next thing is we got that bum and then di. And di is you flick our finger out. Some people use all their fingers, some people just use one finger. So we go bum, dit. It's a kind of flicking movement. And we make sure you leave your thumb behind. Don't send your thumb with it because we need our thumb for something later. So we're going to go bum, dit, bum, dit, bum, dit. I'm getting distracted because I'm actually watching the screen. Bum, dit, bum, dit. Okay? Now you don't have to flick all the strings when you do the dit. The di sweep, you just have to, if you do the bum here, then you can just do those two strings, or you don't have to do all the strings. You don't have to come all the way back to do those strings. So we got bum, di, bum, di. We choose different notes for the. So bum, di, bum, di. The last thing is the ti, which is bum, di, ti. We just grab and pluck the G string with our thumb. Bum ditty, bum ditty. Always the G string with the thumb. Bum ditty, bum ditty. Right. And so you can practice. Grab a chord with your left hand, and try it. Bum ditty, bum ditty, bum ditty, bum ditty, bum ditty, bum ditty, bum. And you can change. Start the bum note on a different string, like the second string. Oh, your G string. You know, and it sounds very different. It sounds melodic. It sounds it has a kind of a rich texture to it. Then you can change chords. Use a G chord. Or an A minor. Okay, or you can change to the E note here. Same chord. Starting on different notes. See how different that sounds? Or we're starting on the C string. It's a really expressive and beautiful style. Another thing I like to get people to do is I get them to practice on the back of their uke, just so they get the rhythmic feel of it. Just go bum ditty, bum ditty, bum ditty, bum ditty. I'll do it slowly. Bum, bum ditty, bum ditty, bum ditty, bum ditty, bum ditty, bum. Ditty bum, ditty bum. Or you can do that on your, you know, if on your leg, which you can't see my leg, but bum, ditty bum, ditty bum, ditty bum, ditty bum, ditty bum, bum, ditty bum, ditty bum, ditty. You can practice that on your leg or on a steering wheel when you're waiting at a traffic light or anything like that. Okay, all for now. That's the clawhammer style. Bye bye.